Shit, boy, I'll pee on the track. Yo, what's going on, big family? It's your dog, the Ultra Melanite, coming to you live and direct once again from Charleston, South Carolina, aka the Holy City, you dig? And today we're going to discuss a little bit of more of Indigenous American culture, namely the Garifuna. Now, I know we don't have a lot of viewers here, but most of our viewers probably already know about the Garifuna. But if you don't, they are an indigenous group of people that inhabit Belize, Honduras, other places in Central America. You dig what I'm saying? They are the descendants of the Carib and the Arawak and the Taino Indians, the indigenous people to the Southeastern Americas. You know, the descendants of the Arawak people, the Carib people, the Taino people. And of course, they may be a little bit of African element. And as the story goes, there was a shipwreck or something like that, and that the Arawak took in, or the Carib took in, the people that was off the shipwreck and gave the men wives and took their women as wives. And they intermarried, and now they got this sort of mixed kind of culture. But with that being said, you would have to also realize that 90% of the people in that culture were 100% indigenous Arawak people. And to this day, the people there retain that Arawak DNA. They are the Arawak people, the Carib people, the Taino Indians. Now, like I said, the reason why we wanted to bring some attention to them boys is because their culture is very similar to ours here in Charleston, South Carolina. They're very similar to the Geechee Gullah people. They are Creole people, you dig? Most of our indigenous cultures here in the United States end up being a Creole culture because the Creoles were a fusion of these European languages and cultures mixed with our indigenous culture. You dig what I'm saying? And if you do your research, if you study, you know, current events, you know that the Garifuna, their culture is being persecuted in Honduras and Belize and Central America the same way our culture is being demonized here. They're kind of trying to force this culture out. It's called racial whitening, you dig? They want everybody to be assimilated and to conform when these people shouldn't have to, because that's their land originally. When you look at the foods they eat, when you look at their music and everything else about their culture, you know that it's indigenous American. You dig? It's not from Africa. It's not from Europe. Now, I know a lot of the people there now are mixed, all right? But there's still a lot of 100% pure blood indigenous brothers there that look like us, right, John? They're very similar to us. They are cousins. We come from the same culture. The other cultures that are similar, like I said, is the Geechee Gullah culture, the Mosquito people, the Maroons, you know, and many more. So like I said, I just wanted to bring a little bit of light around the Garifuna people, an indigenous American culture that's being drowned out, you dig? These are the descendants of the Arawak, the Taino, and the Carib. They're listed as being the Black Caribs, you dig? And like I said, we ain't gonna go too far in the depth about them. We're going to keep going, and we're going to visit different places in the United States and go through the indigenous cultures there and show how they tie in with us here, you know what I'm saying? So y'all let me know how y'all feel about the Garifuna down in the comments below. I think we'll probably do the Mosquito people next, you dig what I'm saying? But y'all let us know what y'all think in the comments below, you know? And the village hidden by the sun, we use grammar to counter the dialectic so that our children are not blinded by the sun, you dig? These Garifuna people were some mainland indigenous Americans that ended up going to inhabit the islands. And everybody know that, you dig? They didn't get off no slave ship. This they land, just like this our land. Peace out, baby. Ultra Melanite 2018.